your job?
Oh, yeah, it's, I'm the vice president of nothing. But yeah, no, it's going good. I...
How's Billy?
He's terrific, yeah. He had a little accident a couple of weeks ago on the playground. He cut himself. Which was scary, but I took him to the hospital myself. And he's gonna have a little scar. But he's fine. I can't help feeling like it was my fault.
Well, no, don't do that. You can't even see it from a distance. I've been watching him from the coffee shop across the street from the school. He's gone big.
You've been watching him from the coffee shop?
I've been back in New York now for 2 months, so...
Yeah, I didn't know that.
That's actually why I wanted to talk to you today. When you last saw me, I was obviously in a pretty bad way.
Shaky.
Yeah, shaky.
I mean, you look lovely.
I'm all speech.
Go ahead.
All my life, I have always been someone's daughter, someone's mother, someone's wife. Even when we were together, I never really knew who I was, and that's why I had to go away. And in London, I feel like I really found myself. I got a job and I got a therapist, a good one. And this is the best I've felt in my whole life. And I feel I've learned a great deal about myself.
Really, I might know you learned.
I've learned that I love my little boy. And that I'm capable of taking care of him.
What do you mean?
I want my son back.
You can't have
it. Don't get defensive and don't try and bully me, okay?
I'm not getting defensive. You walked out of the house 15 months ago.
I don't care. I'm his mother.
From 3,000 miles away. You send the occasional postcard. You think I give you the right...
I never stopped loving him, and I never stopped wanting him.
What makes you so sure that he wants you?
What makes you so sure that he doesn't?
Listen, we're going to sit here and bat back and forth like you did for 8 years. Just like old times.
Do not deny me my son.
Don't tell me what I can and cannot do. Don't talk to me like that, okay?
Well, I anticipated this, so...
Okay.